The general pediatrician can do the diagnosis and assessment of ADHD. They know the family, they know the child, and there's nothing more gratifying than treating a kid with ADHD who is having difficulty in school, having trouble with friends, and being able to see them achieve and produce and get great grades in school and become a very productive member of society as they grow up. And that's our job as pediatricians, to ensure that our kids grow up to be successful, productive adults. The AAP has a tremendous resource called the ADHD Toolkit, third edition, which is very comprehensive. It has all the teacher and parent behavioral rating scales, the history forms, information about ADHD, and how to set up the whole process for an office. It also determines where the child has other mental health issues like oppositional defiant disorder or anxiety disorder or even conduct disorder. Hi, my name is Edward Curry. I'm a general pediatrician. I work with Southern California Permanente Medical Group. I've been at Kaiser Permanente for 40 years doing general pediatrics, ADHD, and autism. With ADHD, it's very important that we have information, and we need information from two settings: home, from the parents, and then from school. And obtaining that information is critically important to making the diagnosis. We usually obtain the information from both the parents, and then they have to go to the school and solicit the teachers, the reports, the IEPs or 504 plans, any type of school documents they have, and they bring them to our office. A pediatrician needs to develop an effective workflow in the office for this whole process. It's critically important that they have a person in the office who can help collate that information for the pediatrician so they can carry on with the diagnosis and treatment. Once we have all the information compiled and we're able to make the diagnosis, then we move on to the next step. If we're looking at treatment with medication, then we need to determine what medication, the dose, and the frequency of that. And that's going to depend on a number of different factors. It's going to depend on the child's weight, his behavioral outlook, any coexisting conditions that are occurring with the child. If we determine that the child needs to be on medication, I talk with the parents, I give them information about how effective it is. Usually it works very well in about 70 to 80% of children who are on stimulant medication, and they can see a really positive effect. The biggest thing that we need to discuss with medication are side effects. And so we also have to inform the parents of the potential side effects of the medication. Once we do that, then they can make a determination whether they want to try, and then we lay out a game plan on how we want to move forward with the treatment. Now, we have a discussion about potential abuse of the medication. From studies we know with ADHD, kids who are on ADHD medication later in life have a lower incidence of substance abuse. The major problem we have to deal with stimulant medication is diversion, and not the child becoming addicted to the medication. And by diversion, we mean someone else taking the child's medication. It's been 6 years since the toolkit was updated. And at this time, we have a survey, and we really would love for you to be able to take the survey and give us feedback on the toolkit. It's going to be critically important that we get your feedback so we can make it better for you to utilize the toolkit fourth edition as it comes out. So please take the survey, give us feedback. It'll help us tremendously. I am on the ADHD toolkit committee and would love to hear from you.